At this point, we're on our final days here at Palmer Station, and it's really a worry. I think our whole trip's just about to be a bust. To be honest, I'm starting to lose a bit of hope in this area. I'm getting junk after junk after junk. It's day two now. I don't know what to do, if we should keep going or move on.
Thousands of miners who lived and worked on this ground for years have left a significant amount of scrap metal, making gold much harder to detect.
It's already out, which doesn't give me much hope on it being gold here either. Are you serious? It's not gold. Surprise, surprise. So this is all the junk I've collected off this ridge this morning. I think it's fair to say that I've reached my junk limit. I'm gonna go down and talk to Andy. He said he wanted to persevere through this area, but we need to come up with a new plan because we're just not getting the gold. Hey.
Hey.
I've just walked all the ridges around these gullies and there's just junk everywhere. I reckon we should head back up to the top of these workings and get onto the ridges.
I don't know. I think it's the wrong choice. We should be staying here where we know the gold is. We haven't got time for walking all over the hills.
So if we leave Palmer with as much gold as we've got right now, are we going to pay our bills?
No, so that's why we shouldn't leave gold ground. We don't walk away from gold ground.
But I'm not finding any gold. I'm going to go. When you're sick of digging up junk, let me know.
Oh, do whatever you want.
It just really shook me because we've never had any disagreements like that before. I thought he'd see the reason in what I was saying to him.
In far north Queensland, prospecting partners Jacqui and Andrew are struggling to find gold, and the stresses on their partnership are showing.
Had a bit of a barney with Jacqui, sort of first time we've ever crossed wires like that, so I was probably a little bit harsh. Yeah, the pressure's building, so I think it got the better of me there for a minute. It's been a long trip, a lot of driving, like thousands and thousands of kilometres, big days, hot weather. It's just everything sort of compounding, you know, like really, yeah, put us both in a bit of a place.
This is looking really good, actually. You can see there's loads of river gravel here. Let's see if I can find some gold. I've had a little swing of this ground here and I haven't really got many targets, but that's actually not a bad thing because I've been digging up that much junk that I feel like I've actually walked far enough to get away from the junk but stay on what looks like good gold ground too. Definitely a nice sound. Crossing my fingers for this one. So we're about a foot deep now. Yep, okay, it's out. Come on, big gold. Please, please, please. All right. It's still in there. It's heavy. Oh my God! Right. Oh, I'm so happy. Yes, yes. Woo! Oh my God. That's got to be like close to 10 grams, hey? Oh my God, what a monster. That's probably $1,000 in my hand right there. I don't really care what Andy says. He's coming up here and we're gonna dig this ground out. You! Thank you, Palmer. Andy!
What are you running for?
Andy, wait. Put your hand out.
Whoa, hey. Wow, that's a chunk and a half.
We needed this.
Well done, mate. You're a champion. I never should have doubted you for a second, eh? I've seen you find plenty of patches of gold.
I shouldn't have taken it out on you.
Nah, it's all right.
But I found gold.
You did.
So let's everything go. Everything is better.
Well, I'm done with this gully then. Let's go.
Yeah, let's
show
it.
Show me. This spot up here Jackie's found, it's up above all those gullies with the workings, right at the top of the ridge basically, and you know, it's a great looking spot. It's got all the vegetation we want to see, and there's river rock all over the ridge. They're two things we always look for.
Ta-da-da.
Yeah, that's a crater. Plan now is to get these coils on the ground and find out just how much there is in this part of the world. Seems to be, a, you know, basically no junk up here on this ridge at all. So, you know, when you get a target, it sort of gets your hopes up really quick instead of just thinking you're just digging out another bit of rusty tin.
That's good. Yeah, I got a nice signal here. Man, it would be so good to get another one now.
Hey, can you hear that?
I can hear you digging that gravel. I'll come and help you, eh?
Yeah, for sure.
Wow, that is just straight into river wash, eh?
Yeah, river wash everywhere. Listen to that.
Yeah, pretty sure you got another one there, eh?
Get into it. It's tough going digging through this. Big river rocks all over the place. Oh.
There you go.
Yep, all right, onto it, El Scoopo.
Where do you reckon it is?
Here.
All right.
Come on.
Listen to it. It's plenty noisy. Oh, look, look, look.
Yeah!
You're on a roll, mate. Look at that, another nice chunker too. I reckon you'll put a half an ounce of gold out of here in these two nuggets.
Woo!
Jack yes. Patch, nice job,
yes.
Mate. Really done a great job, like.
Thank you for your help.
No, that's the easy part.
Finally, I've seen why people come to Palmer.
I got onto one here, Jackie.
Yeah, I'm just digging a target now.
Yeah, right.
It's definitely a serious place for serious prospectors. It's super remote and it's a big trip, but it's worth it, hey. I reckon mine's gonna be bigger.
No, I don't reckon.
That just proves there's some serious gold in Palmer.
Ready?
Here you go.
Yes.
Well done.
Yes! You beauty.
Woo! Hey, are you ready for this?
Oh, yeah, I am.
Nearly 3,000 kilometres east in tropical Queensland, Jacqui and Andrew are about to find out if their month-long expedition along Palmer River has been profitable or not.
Well, that's awesome. I'll keep the heavy one.
The team needs another 2.5 ounces of gold just to cover the $10,000 expenses for the month.
Now, costs this year are actually reasonably high already. Obviously, we've got the long trip, extra fuel, food, we've had to hire another car. Yeah, everything costs more when you're this remote. Oh well, let's find out what we got in this bad boy. Have a look at that for a pile.
Far out.
4.66 ounces of gold. Hey, how good's that, mate?
Oh my god.
That's Jack's patch there, right there. Haven't even put the big ones on yet.
Seriously, best patch.
I know.
All right, here we go. And the final tally is
5.74 ounces of gold, mate. Nice. That's wicked. That's what we came here for.
Man.
That's the river of gold right there.
We are seriously out of the red, well and truly, hey.
Yeah, that pays for everything. That pays for the car hire, food, fuel, all costs, and some left over.
The nearly $15,000 haul has covered their expenses, given them a wage, and shown they have a future as exploration miners.
Now I'm actually really sad that it's time to go.
Well, they're going to start mustering in a few days, so we've got no choice. We've got to go.
But you know what? We've got all these locations to send through to them. I'm sure we'll be able to come back.
You know, I'm super proud of you, mate. You've worked like a champion and we've got through it together as a team.
Tell you what, this trip has just been the most stressful up and down journey of all the emotions, hey. Couldn't have ended on a better point.